So far this week, I've had a gas bill, one from the electric and the car insurance. Sometimes I feel like I'm running just to stand still.
You are.
I ain't told Daryl, of course. I mean, he's got enough on his plate, but it ain't easy, Dorian. I went up Sainsbury's yesterday and nearly went into shock at the checkout.
Why, did someone offer to pack you shopping?
Prices. Do you know what a box of tea bags cost today?
No, but then I don't know what a box of tea bags cost yesterday. I haven't had intimate contact with a tea bag since Marcus introduced me to Earl Grey. Of course it costs a little more.
But all you have to do is flash your plastics and Marcus picks up the tab.
These are not plastics.
I mean your credit cards, not your frumpy bits.
I see. Well, of course Marcus picks up the tab. I'm sure Daryl would pick up your tab if he didn't have his hands full of mailbags.
He's not doing mailbags no more. He's reproofing sou'westers for lifeboatmen.
Well, as long as it's creatively fulfilled. Fancy a swap?
Oh, yes, please.
Actually, and I don't want this going beyond this gym, I don't have any credit cards to flash at the moment.
What? Someone pinch him?
Yes. But Marcus hasn't told the police. He said the thief is spending less money than I was.
Really?
No, Tracy, it's a joke.
Oh, because he's got the smack of truth about it. So what's really happened to your flexible friends then?
Marcus has instituted an economy drive and locked all my cards in the office safe. The business is going through a slow patch, you see.
Really?
Yeah. We're even talking about getting a cheaper car. Tracy, I've just had a brainwave. Have you ever thought about selling Daryl's Jaguar?
What?
Well, it would solve both our problems. You'd make some ready cash, and we'd have a car we know has been treated with kid gloves, if only to prevent fingerprints.
No way. When Daryl was sent down, he made me promise to keep everything exactly as it was. Well, why do you think I'm doing all this bending and thrusting?
Well, it's just a thought. I mean, you hardly ever drive it. And when Daryl gets out, you can imagine the insurance he'll have to pay as a professional bank robber. Ah!
I thought I could smell four sweaty armpits. You don't down here, Dorian. It ain't a rowing machine.
Don't annoy me, Sharon.
Here, Trace. You'll never guess who I see getting out of a brand new sports car at the parade.
You're right, I'll never guess, so you might as well tell me.
All right, spoil sport. Lisa.
Lisa who?
Lisa Slag.
What, that old bag from up your flats? What, was having it off for your Chris? What's she doing round here?
Earning a packet. So I thought, seeing as we're a bit short, I'd ask her how she's doing it.
I can imagine how she's doing it.
Oh, she ain't working horizontal no more. She's in the perfume game now. Judging by the niff in here, I brought her round in a nick of time.
Oh, you brought her round? She's in my ass. You let her cross my steps?
Yeah. Didn't I say?
All you've got to remember is every encounter is an opportunity. When you go up Tesco's, flog some to the checkout girl. You get on a bus, flog some to the driver. You go down a bingo, target all the grannies. And once you've got a customer, you get them to flog it to their friends. Piece of cake. Relax, Tracy, I ain't nicked nothing. There's nothing you've got I can't afford. I pulled down five big ones last week.
And you still find time to sell all that perfume?
I'm not ashamed of my past. So I went with men to pay the rent and feed me kids, don't everyone?
No.
Anyway, you didn't pay the rent. You was on rent strike like the rest of us.
That's all ancient history. Now, do you want to get rich quick or not?
Of course we do.
I just don't see us selling cheap
Then sink. Shut up and you might learn something. Right. Let's suppose in the first month you sell four large bottles of Aromantique at £3.28 profit a bottle, you'll make £13.12 profit.
It's a hell of a way from £5,000 a week.
That's only month one. Now, in month two, you don't only sell four bottles, you recruit two new distributors who also sell four bottles.
And then we make £5,000.
And then you make another £13.12.
Wow. Get the smelling salt, shall?
A lot of people lose their enthusiasm after month two.
Oh, we won't. Not with over £26 to show for our...
This is where it gets exciting.
You excited, shall?
Wetting myself, trust.
Because you make commission on everything your recruits can flog and everything their recruits can flog and everything
Yeah, we get the general drift, but what does it amount to?
Let's just say, with my network of recruits, I can make £20,000 a month without getting out of bed.
So no change there, then?
I've given you enough chances, Tracy Stubbs.
Oh, no, hold on, Lise. Don't listen to her, I'm game.
I didn't say I wasn't interested. All right, we'll give it a bash.
Congratulations, you just made a life-changing decision.
Oh, no, someone up. What does this gear actually smell like?
What's that got to do with anything?
Yes, it does smell remarkably like your favourite perfume, doesn't it? And at a fraction of the price. So you too can feel sensuous and desirable without breaking the bank. Breaking the bank?
Here, Shell, you'll never guess what I just did to the postman.
You never. Hope you didn't crush his circulars.
I only flogged him some aftershave, didn't I?
What, out of the magic box?
Yep, it was brilliant. I just said, morning, Peter, what's your favourite pong? And he told me, and I told him not to be such a cheeky little beggar, what was his favourite aftershave, I meant. And he said, and I said, don't you think this one is very reminiscent of it? And he said, yeah, it is as it happens, after I explained to him what reminiscent meant. And I said, what would you say if I told you you could have 100 mil of this for the price of 25 mil of that?
Yeah.
And he said, nah. And I said, yeah. And he said, leave it at. And I said, straight up, do you want some? And he said, do you mean the aftershave or what? And I said, what? And he said, I'll see you tonight. And I said, I'm a married woman.
And then he bought some.
The big bottle, there and then, paid cash.
See, I told you, Trace. Lisa was right. We are going to be two rich bitches.
What are you doing here? We were supposed to meet outside Rumbelows.
Well, I finished early, so I thought I'd come on and soak my feet.
But
I didn't take my key.
Well, why not?
Because I thought we was meeting outside Rumbelows. Get a grip, Trace, get a grip. So, how'd you get on then?
Oh, not bad for the first time, Matt. You?
I had an interesting day.
Me too. Very eye-opening. There's a lot to this selling game, you know.
Yeah, well, you mustn't expect to run before you can walk. Not that I expect to be able to walk again this month. So, how much to get rid of then?
How do you mean?
I mean, how much Aromantique did you part with in exchange for cash or cheques under £50 supported by a valid cheque guarantee card?
Look, it ain't just a case of taking orders, Shell. Like the handbook says, you've got to build up your territory, do your market research, develop your contacts, suss the opposition.
You didn't sell any, did you?
You put it like that.
I got rid of all of mine.
All of it? How'd you manage that?
I flung the old stinking lot into the canal.
Never.
I did. It was a complete waste of time. I must have gone into 50 shops and offices and didn't get a single tickle. Not even in Lovecraft.
Oh, Sharon, the canal.
Yeah, well, make the fish feel sensuous and desirable, wouldn't it?
Lisa would go balmy.
Oh, tough titty. It's her fault I didn't flog any. She saturated Chigwell. The bank, the pet shop, Dewhurst, do it all. I knew we should never have trusted that slag.
What do you mean, you knew? It was you what talked me into it.
Yeah, well, once I see Lisa's clothes and that car, I mean, you can't deny she's done all right, Trace.
Oh, of course she's done all right. She was in on the ground floor, but we're on the top floor and the lift's broke.
So now what?
Oh, don't ask me. Back to square one, I suppose, with a stack of outgoings and not enough incomings.
Not exactly back to square one, Trace.
Oh, blimey. That's another £300 a month. Where am I going to get that from?
1988 Jaguar, 18,000 miles.
Yeah, I know it's below average, but my husband hasn't been getting out much lately. Yeah, air conditioning, leather seats, stereo, all the bits. Right, I'll hold.
I thought you was going to try and flog it to Dorian.
I am, but I'm trying to find out what it's worth. Yes, I'm still here. Right, and you'll put it on for 20k O-N-O. 20 kono.
20 grand or nearest offer.
Oh, right you are then. And it goes on the computer straight away. Great. My credit card number, hold on.
Tracy asked me to pop in for coffee.
Must be a whole new experience for you, Dory, getting invited round.
Lovely. Thank you. Bye. Oh, glad you could pop in. Fancy a coffee?
Is it real? Or is it freeze-dried and you try to fool your guests by imitating a puking cat while you boil the cake?
It's Maxwell ass.
Lovely. Tracy, Sharon, I hope you don't take this amiss, but people are talking.
I know. People have been talking for nearly a million years. It's one of the things that distinguishes us from the higher apes. That and file faxes.
What exactly have people been talking about, Dorian?
People are talking, Tracy, about two of our neighbours hawking cheap scent round Chigwell like a couple of gypsies.
Who's doing that then?
Nothing wrong with gypsies. I like gypsies.
Well, so do I. They're very picturesque. They make wonderful violinists and very skillful scrap metal dealers, but in Chigwell...
Oh, you're so stuck up. Just because we don't make people pay through the nose for fancy packaging.
Tracy, remember the handbook?
Aye.
Lesson one, don't antagonise the customer.
Customer? Oh, I see. You want me to buy some. Oh, why not? Order me a bottle for my mother.
Oh, right. Which one?
It doesn't matter. She had a slight stroke 3 years ago. Now she's got no sense of smell.
The perfect punter.
Oh. So, how's the car hunting going?
We've seen nothing we fancy.
Have a Viscount, Dorian.
Oh, very nice. Thank you, Tracy.
Dorian, I suppose you're hoping that Tracy will change her mind about selling you the Jag.
Sharon, you're psychic.
Must be me gypsy blood.
Change me mind about selling you the Jag.
Wonderful. But you were so adamant.
I know, but you were right. It will want a new car when it gets there, and it's silly just letting it collect dust.
Yes, and of course the mortgage interest rate just went up again. 15,000.
What?
We'll give you 15,000 for the car.
Computer car said it's worth at least 20.
Yes, but they don't know it belongs to a convicted felon, do they?
You know where the door is, don't you, Dorian? It's that large opening at the end of the hall, slightly smaller than your mouth.
She's got some neck. Hello. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
See, the Beatles are getting back together again then.
Someone only wants to have a look at Daryl's Jag.
Really? That was quick.
Yep, seems he was on the lookout for a car just like it. Come on.
Where are we going?
Outside. I'll wash, you can wipe.
Mrs. Stubbs.
It's me.
I've come about the Jaguar.
Oh, great.
Blimey, that was quick. She's only just put it on the computer.
It's a lovely car.
Yeah.
We'll be heartbroken to part with it.
Not that we got to sell it, ain't I?
Oh, we haven't got to sell it. It's just that we're bored with the colour, eh, Shell?
Now, the price is no problem if it's the car I want.
Well, computer car said it's worth at least 20 kono.
Now, if you could just pull the bonnet release for me.
Ah, you got me there. Look, I know this makes me sound like a right gonk, but the boot and the bonnet are a mystery to me.
Yeah, I'll get it.
How do you know?
Chris borrowed a Jag once. Oh, he said he borrowed it. Then why did he respray it and change the number plates the next day?
That seems in order. Do you have the registration document?
Oh, yeah. Get us that, Shell.
Yeah?
Thank you. Oh, I see your husband registered at care of a P.O. Box number in the Scilly Isles.
Sure, he had his reasons.
Not to worry. If I could just take it for a test drive.
Yeah, of course, help yourself.
Oh, I better check my bike fits in the boot.
We'll help you with that.
Thank you.
Oh, that's good, isn't it? Clever, isn't it? Yeah. I'll take you get the wheels. Mind fingers?
Got it.
Yeah. Oh. In you go. Once that's
stretched
clear.
What the? Isn't it my Daryl's Jake? Yeah. Yeah, I know it's been repossessed. That's what your underling said. Yeah, but how does my sister get it back? Oh, right. Gotcha. Thanks very much. Bye.
Well?
It's back in the showroom. You can have it back by the end of the week if you pop along with 18 fares and dim readies. Doddle.
This is the last straw. I might as well go upstairs and slash me wrists.
What with, your lady shave?
World's falling apart.
Oh, calm down, Trace. You ain't on Kilroy.
Oh, ain't you got no sympathy?
No, I'm too angry for sympathy. And so should you be. I mean, what sort of husband is he, your Daryl, eh? Any decent villain would have stashed away some moody money for his wife and loved ones. Oh, no, not your old man. He didn't even pay cash for his car. Are you sure this house ain't rented?
Cheek. No one pays rent here. Though one of us might have to start.
What's the point? You're wasting your breath.
Maybe, but what have I got to lose?
The sight of one eye?
Hello.
You want something?
I hope you don't mind me asking, but what's your favourite perfume?
You what?
Your favourite perfume.
Are you taking the piss?
No, I just thought that you might be interested in a perfume that smells almost the same as your favourite, but for less than...
Now, listen, you stupid cow. I have to go without fags to find the fare to visit my old man here. I can't afford soap, let alone poxy perfume.
Sorry, I didn't mean anything.
I've seen you here showing out week after week with your flash clothes and your jewellery and your streaky hair. What do you know about going without?
She knows. She's suffered. Just had her jag repossessed.
Look, I've said me sorries, haven't I? There you are.
Right, you lucky people. Howe, Walker, Jenkin, Fowler, come on down. Piat, Greenwood, Stubbs, Scargill. Some relation, I hope. Theodopolopodus. Mrs. Theodopolopodus?
Present.
I must say, you don't look like any of the photos your old man's got over his bunk.
Oh, fair enough. You don't look like none of the blokes I've had in mind.
Coming in, then.
No, thanks. I only come to keep my sister company.
Your old man's going to be really cut up.
Yeah? Well, you tell me who's doing the cutting and I'll send him a thank you card.
I'm making a guitar in woodwork.
Yeah?
Yeah. It's slow going, mine, because I keep all the tools blunt for security reasons. Right. You all right, Tracy? Look a bit off colour.
No, I'm fine.
When I've finished it, I'm going to take lessons. You changed your perfume?
Yeah. Do you like it?
No, it's horrible.
Thanks.
No, I don't mean it's horrible. It's just... You know, I hate you changing things.
I know, but I'm trying to make some money, Daryl.
Yeah, you haven't forgotten my cigar, have you?
No, of course not.
What's this? Where's my Havana?
Do you know how much they cost?
It's only one a fortnight. This is pathetic. I mean, you can't imagine Winston Churchill saving the Empire with one of these pitiful little things stuck in his gob, can you?
They say size isn't everything.
Ha, bloody ha.
I'm sorry, Dale, but money's been very tight lately.
I look forward to a good smoke.
Everything's going up. The mortgage rate's gone through the roof. I don't suppose you'd notice living in here rent-free.
Tracy.
I'm sorry, shut off. But you just don't know. If only you'd put some money aside for me.
It's all in the house, Tracy.
Well, I can't find it.
No, I mean, it's all tied up in the bricks and mortar, isn't it? When we sell, we'll be millionaires.
Are you saying I should sell?
Over my dead body. That house is for when I get out. It's an investment for me middle years.
I ain't gonna have no middle years if I don't get some cash soon. I'll be dead of starvation.
Oh, don't you think you're going a bit over the top?
No, I'm not. I'm sinking, Daryl. Look. These are all bills. Here. And there's Garfield's school fees.
No way are you taking him out of public school.
I had to pawn that gold watch.
Oh, not the one I gave you.
No, the one I gave you. And then there's the jag.
Oh, no. Don't tell me you flogged me jag.
No, of course not.
Oh, thank God for that. Tracy, you must never, under any circumstances, sell my Jaguar.
I won't. I promise.
Right.
But what am I supposed to do, Daryl?
Look, all right, I wasn't going to tell you this, but as it happens, I do have a nice little wad tucked away.
What? Then why haven't you never said?
I was keeping it for an emergency.
Daryl, this is an emergency.
Yeah. All right, I suppose.
So where is it then? You know I don't take sugar.
It's good for shock, isn't it?
Yeah, well, not as good for shock as being told your old man's hidden 25 grand in the spare tire of his Jag the day after it's been repossessed.
Look, it ain't all bad, Trace. You owed 18 grand on it, so you're only really 7,000 out of pocket.
Oh, so that's all right then, isn't it? I mean, fancy hiding money in a car you ain't even paid for. It's criminal.
Well, he is a criminal, isn't he? Hold on, hold on, all is not lost. Why don't we mosey on up to the garage, ask to look inside the spare wheel, and bingo!
3 years for receiving.
Oh, yeah. Didn't think of that.
No, you never think of nothing, Sharon. No, we're never going to see that money now.
Not necessarily. I'm working well here. Why don't we ask if we can take the car for a test drive, run it round to one of them tyre places and do a quick swap?
And you really think they're just going to let someone get in that car and drive off with it?
Well, you did.
Stuffed, Sharon.
Oh, better still. We take the Nissan up the garage, say we want to part exchange it for the Jag, sign an HP agreement for the balance, drive it off. Bob's your uncle, Fanny's your aunt, and your gran's in the Air Force.
Sharon, that is the most brilliant idea you've ever had.
Good afternoon, madam.
I want to buy the car of the week.
Tracy! You've got to be a bit cagey.
Why?
We might be able to knock them down a couple of hundred on the price.
Oh, why bother? It's 25 grand in the boot.
Yeah, well, he don't know that, does he? We'd like to have a look at some of your low-mileage XJ6s, please.
Including your car of the week.
Certainly. All our motors come with a full service history and a year's warranty. Parts and labour.
It's good. It's good, isn't it, Shell?
Oh, very good, Chase.
So, tell us about your car of the week.
Amongst others.
Right. Well, it's a very fine example, and we're practically giving it away.
Really? Give us the keys then and we'll shoot off.
Very good. No, I mean giving it away figuratively speaking. It's 3,000 under book price.
Really? How come?
Sharon knows.
Well, strictly between us three, we're clearing it for a finance company. You see, it used to be owned by this notorious bank robber. Nasty bit of work. He'd registered it in the Scilly Isles and never paid a single instalment. It would never have been recovered, only his bimbo wife goes and tries to sell it through computer. She has a direct line through to Scotland Yard. Everyone knows that.
Does everyone know that? I didn't know that. Did you know that, Tracy?
If I did, it must have slipped my mind. Look, let's cut the waff away. I've got a 1989 Nissan Sunny Coupe, 13,000 miles.
One angry lady owner.
What are you giving me against the Jag?
Tracy, how can you think about sex at a time like this?
I'll just go and check with the manager.
Oh, it's locked.
It don't matter. I think we pulled it off, Trace.
Taking that car?
To the workshop for a pre-delivery check.
Oh, that's all right. I don't want it delivered. I'll take it with me now.
No, I'm afraid you don't understand. You see, since we've been standing here talking, someone's phoned up and bought the car, sight unseen.
You what? I don't believe it.
But we do have an almost identical car on the forecourt over there. Now, I'm sure we can come to some arrangement.
You know where you can arrange your almost identical car?
What?
I'll give you a clue. Takes a hell of a lot of industrial lubricant to get it in.
And a highly skilled medical team to get it out again.
Take it easy, you said. Don't be too hasty, you said. If we'd just gone straight in and done the deal, we'd have 25 grand spread out on that coffee table right now.
Oh, give it a rest, Trace. Look, if it hadn't been for my brilliant idea, we'd never even have been in with a chance.
Have I come at a bad time?
Oh, even the good times are bad, Dorian.
Hey, what's the matter?
Oh, you know what's the matter. The car's the matter.
Look, Tracy, I can explain.
Explain what?
I didn't do it to upset you or annoy you or spite you. It was just such an incredible bargain, I couldn't resist it.
What are you rabbiting on about, Dorian?
Well, I was driving past Merritt's, you know, the Jaguar dealer, and what should I see in the window but your Daryl's car as car of the week? So I phoned Marcus on the car phone, he called them, and when we found out it was an HP repossession, we thought we must buy it before all of Chigwell found out you couldn't afford to keep up the payments. That's why I'm apologising, I did her a favour. Was it something I said?
Oh. It's got sentimental value. Come on. I love you.
Maybe they have got gypsy blood.
What'll I do when you are far away and I am blue? What'll I do? I'm alone with only dreams of you that won't come true. What'll I do?